Okay, so this is my BMW Z4 35i. So it would have the same engine as in your 335i's as well, and a bunch of other Beamers. It is running horribly. I'm gonna get in and show you in just a second. Okay, here we are in the car. We'll turn it on. It doesn't idle smooth. It idles, it feels like it's barely running. We'll see if it acts up like that. It was running horrible when I parked it. I'm gonna back it out. We got a reduced power light coming on. And I have to say, even though it's not running good right now, it sounds a ton better than it did when I parked it, so it was really bad then. You can see maybe the needle moving a little bit, too. It's getting worse the longer I let it sit, and it's actually starting to... The camera shaking isn't because I'm shaking, it's because the car is shaking. Reduced power, it's idling horribly, and when I sit in the car, it's like shaking. So next is trying to fix it. Okay, so what am I going to do about the bad idle? Well, the very first thing I'm going to try is I'm going to try to clean out the Vanos actuators. And the Z4, they're right under here. You can see two sensors, one, two, those adjust the Vanos. So I've got this one right here and that one right there. Those sensors are attached to it. That bolt right there and a subsequent one. There's a 10 mil, I believe it's a 10 mil on that one, and then one other that's above it that you can't, right up there that you can barely see. Hi guys, this is my Z4 with the 35i engine in it. That would be the N54, the twin turbo version. It was running really terrible, so I decided to pull the Vanos actuators. Those are found right where those paper towels are. Didn't film me pulling it out. They're already on the ground. It only takes two 10 millimeter bolts out, and they just wiggle right out. Not hard at all. Took me 20 minutes. These are the actuators. They are filthy. The oil is terrible. So if cleaning them does improve anything, I sort of have high hopes because they are so such ugly condition. I'm hoping that after we clean them up, it smooths out the idle, and we'll swap a whole oil change. If that does it, I'll post it. If not, hey, it doesn't hurt anything. It just costs a little bit of time, not much, no money. So, next step, you can follow me on cleaning these. A little bit more close up of what these things look like. They're pretty filthy. The oil is black. I got no one to blame but myself for that one. It needs to be changed. I thought it had been changed not long before I bought the car, but I should have changed it right away because it looks horrid. Here's the other one. Not as bad. Just for reference, they're interchangeable is my understanding, but this is my upper and this is the lower, or intake and exhaust if I'm not mistaken. So, got some carb cleaner here. I'm gonna spray them down with carb cleaver, dry them out with paper towels. Then I'm probably gonna get the air compressor too and see if I can blow anything else off it as well. All right, now just wiping them down with paper towels. Getting as much of the gunk off as I can mechanically.
lot of junk in there. It's looking better. I'm gonna still put a couple more rounds of juice in there. Before you go putting these back in your beamer, make sure they're all dry. You don't need it mixing with the oil. All that cleaner that might be in there. So dry them off, get everything out of them. Right now we're looking pretty clean on this one. Okay, so this is what they look like now. I'd say a million better. But I'm gonna blow them out with compressed air to make sure I don't have any carb cleaner still left in it. If I had to pick which one was the worst off, I'd say my lower. Here's what the rags look like after getting the dirt out of them. And that's not, I mean, that's not even counting the oil that'll let drip out overnight. So here, we're gonna get some compressed air into them. The lower, I'm still getting gunk out of. Upper seems okay. Lower still a little bit. I'm gonna put another round through these and we'll do it until it's clean. Well, there we go. This is it all cleaned up with the O-rings and seals on it. This is what it looks like all cleaned up with the O-ring and the seal just laid out on the, so you can see it. Okay, next time I'm gonna slap it in there and see if it'll stay out at idle. Okay, this is the first startup after cleaning the vanhouse actuators and putting in fresh oil. I'm gonna check the oil level here. Okay, engine oil's okay. Idling is steady. Still have my check engine light. I'm gonna shut it down and I back it out and take it for a drive. Okay, so it's been about a week since I did the vanos and oil change, and I have to tell you, it's made the world of difference. But I figured since I just did a brief idle, I'd do a quick start up here right now, and we can take a drive on it. You can hear it in a little bit more detail. Okay, here's startup. It's idling great. The low power concerns have gone away. I did have to reset the engine light with a code reader, but besides that, that was the only thing that required a special tool after that. Even without resetting the code, resetting the check engine light, it runs great. But now all the warning lights are off, the seatbelt light's on because I'm just sitting here. But here, you can even listen to it, it sounds a whole lot better too. That sound to how it was before. Let's take it for a quick drive. Idle is nice and steady and flat. Well, if you stuck with me throughout the vanos
actuator. If your BMW is running rough or has some issues, I would really recommend just changing out the Vanos actuators. You don't even have to, you don't even have to buy new ones. Just clean them out. It's made a world of a difference on my car. Like literally, I was worried my car was not gonna get home, and I limp around garbage all the time, so it was really running very rough. And changing the actuators, well, cleaning them out, and putting it in a new oil change, night and day difference in how the car runs now. It's so smooth. Well, if this has been useful for you, also feel free to subscribe. I always am working on the cars, BMW and Land Rover in particular right now. And if this was helpful at all, give it a like. Hope you guys have a great ride.